Today we're driving down the East Fjords. This is an incredible mountain behind me. I don't know what it's called, but it's along the east coast of Iceland. And this is a very cool lighthouse, orange. Here at our hotel, which is on like this remote farm. We've got one more day and one more night to go on our tour with the Trolls Expeditions people, which we booked through Guide to Iceland. But we are here for one night, and we had a local dinner here at the restaurant part of the hotel, and it was super yummy. Basically everything that is available at that restaurant, almost everything, is grown on the farm here or caught from a nearby river or lake. And the chef is actually the owner himself, and he cooked everything and it was amazing. Like, this guy is talented. This place is super cute, kind of like very Scandinavian chic, super cute and really cozy. So we're looking forward to having our night here, and hopefully the sky clears up a little bit because it's quite remote and there's not a lot of light pollution around here, so it would be a really good place to catch some northern lights.
So these windows basically look out into the darkness outside. So if we see some northern lights tonight, this is like the perfect viewing spot. We are at a geothermal power station.
It's stinky.
A sunny day, but it's cold outside. It tingles in my heart. Breathing air that clears my mind. I'm all for a good start. I hear the jingle bells, people singing about love. It feels like I'm a kid, like I'm forever young.
Apparently in there used to be a nature bath, but now the temperatures are way too hot because of the magma underneath. This, I think the ridge here is a tectonic plate, right?
Celebrate this day. Everyone's smiling and it's snowing. It's the time of year again. I'm happy you're here. My winter wonderland. I'm walking around making small talk with people that pass me by. I share a laugh, it gives me joy that everyone's having a good, good time. I hear the jingle bell.
A different nature bath,
and it's basically like the Blue Lagoon.
Unfortunately, it's all been booked out, so we're only just having lunch here. We got mushroom soup, rye bread, and butter and smoked salmon. Yum.
like I'm a kid, like I'm forever young. And that's why I wanna sing about the Christmas on its way. A reason to hang around and celebrate this day. Everyone's smiling and it's snowing. It's the time of year again. I'm happier here, my winter wonderland. No.
This is apparently where the 13-year-old lads live.
My winter wonderland is the time of year. My winter wonderland, my winter wonderland. I wanna sing about the Christmas on its way.
So we did a short walk here and it's been so nice. It's like the snow is getting heavier, but it's such a cool experience, literally. Apparently the tale is that the trolls in this area, if they get caught by sunlight, they'll freeze and turned into stone. And there's like a couple of like rock formations that look like they could be the faces of the trolls. One's there, one's this one, more Santa looking one.
Everyone's smiling and it's snowing. It's the time of year again. I'm happier here, my winter wonderland.
It's very cold and it's snowing. We've had good weather for the majority of the trip so far though, and like even with the snow it kind of adds like another like element of magic, so it's quite nice. We only have one night in Akureyri and we decided to come to Rub 23, also because there were a few others that were closed, but Rub 23 comes highly recommended. It's like everything is basically local and it's kind of like a fusion style, so Icelandic modern food. We've got their most popular dish here, which is Rub 23 sushi pizza. So the pizza and sushi was amazing, and now we've got
our mains, beef tenderloin from a local farm, and the Arctic char. Yum yum yum.
We've just been walking down this, I guess one of the main roads in Akureyri, to try to find ice cream. There's apparently this really good ice cream place called Bernier. Anyway, it was closed, so now we're walking back in the snow to see if maybe the one near our house will be opened. Today we are going to go whale watching. We're going with the company Fjords. We've got our gear on. I would definitely recommend wearing a shorter jacket on this day because you can wear your shorter jacket underneath this, which I didn't do because I was wearing like a long jacket. So, and we're going on these boats.
Oh, hello. Oh my goodness. Wow.
So sorry about the mess, but we've just had a kerfuffle of stuff, but we also got upgraded to a junior suite. So that's very nice. So anyway, we had a bit of a kerfuffle. Essentially, the tour ran late and there were all these bus transfers between the tour company that was late. It was just a long drive generally today from the point where we started. Included in that was the whole whale watching, which took another like 3 hours, which was amazing, so that was great. But because of the long bus rides and the bus driver who was supposed to pick us up to go to Reykjavik was late, we essentially missed our slot to test the COVID PCR and antigen test that we had booked ourselves in to fly back to London. We'd missed that for the day. We had to come back to the hotel, figure out a new testing slot first thing tomorrow morning, and also book new set of flights. So that is painful. That's all done now. It's about 9 p.m. now. We really need to eat.
So when I said it was like 9, it's more like 9:50. And so basically everything's closed because of COVID, except for like takeaway places, like this Greek place over here. So we are just getting some souvlaki to take away and to have back at our room, which I actually do not mind because our room is so nice.
All packed and all our things for the next day all laid out, so that's great. That couch over there is actually also like the most comfortable thing ever. Love it. I could definitely get used to the junior suite life. We have just finished like packing and just like making sure that we are all set for all our tests, as well as like filling out locator forms and stuff like that for our trip to London. So here's hoping to getting to London tomorrow as planned. So we've got a really early start. We've asked the hotel to help us reserve like a car that's going to take us to our test center and then kind of wait for us and then drop us off at the airport. So we are now shopping at duty free at the airport. There's actually like lots of shops and lots of Nordic products as well, like Icelandic products as well. So it's really cool. I'm seeing these cute little Santas everywhere and I finally found one for myself. They're so cute. Overall, this Iceland trip has been amazing. We got to see so many wonderful things, like actually wonderful things. And the food has actually been pretty good like throughout the whole trip as well. The hotels have kind of been hit and miss on the troll expeditions part of the journey. So we booked through Guide to Iceland and we added the option to kind of like upgrade, like get the best hotels, but that kind of only applies in Reykjavik on the first day and on the last day of the tour, whereas all of the stuff in the middle is booked by Trolls Expeditions and then everyone's kind of put in the same spot and they're all kind of about like 2 to 3 star hotels. And there were some really good ones like the cabin that we stayed at the and the farm hotel. Some of the hotels were like not great, and in Reykjavik the hand-picked hotels have been really, really good. Tour guide was able to adapt to the driving conditions and to the conditions of the tour really well for us, and kind of like,
you know, show us something else if another part of the road might like was closed, or if we weren't going to get to somewhere in time, to show us other beautiful things along the way.
And the other thing is just kind of like the communication, like if there was more communication about timing and things, that would be a lot more helpful, and just trying to get the other legs of the tours to kind of keep to their schedule so that the overall tour could be kept to schedule. That would have been great, but you know, in hindsight, we should have given ourselves more flex in terms of timing. But we did actually ask our like Guide to Iceland agent, when would the tour actually end and when would we actually get back to Reykjavik, because we have to get our tests because our flight is 7:40 the next day. And they're like, yep, that's fine, no problem, you'll be in Reykjavik at 6 p.m. We told our tour guide as well. He kept saying, yeah, that's fine, it should be fine. Even if the other bus driver was on time, it was really pushing it.
Although we didn't get to see the Northern Lights, I think that with what we saw this trip, it was like more than enough already. Like, it was just so, so wonderful.